I wasn't born to be the best, but I was born to do this. And I know that because I'm still so enthusiastic to do it that it's never a chore. I don't want to retire. I want to keep doing it. I want to do more, more and more all the time. So I was always born to want to be involved in music one way or another. I'm Joe Elliott. I sing in Def Leppard and I sing in the Down and Outs. When my mum bought a guitar and I was just infatuated with it, and I said to my dad, I want one. He said, well, you can have one once you learn to play your mum. So I had my mum teach me. Then I got a guitar. Then I realised I didn't want to play guitar like, say, Phil or Vivian do. I wasn't bothered about all this whittling stuff. I just wanted to play chords so I could sing. So of course, obviously, you look back now and you go, well, obviously, he just wanted to sing and play. So that's what Bob Dylan did. That's what Mark Bolan did, Bowie, Ian Hunter, all these people that are my heroes, this is what they did. If you wanna play, you gotta pay the toll. So we can dance, but we got soul. You've got to have all the enthusiasm to want to do it, but it's never gone, it's never waned. My dad bought a cassette recorder, push down buttons. My mum played guitar. I wrote a song and somehow we managed to record it. And I've still got a cassette of it. I was 8. And it's called Going Forever. And it's about a girl leaving me, which I didn't really know much about from a personal point of view, but obviously the songs I was hearing on the radio, that's all it was. It was all relationship stuff, which stuck with me a lot actually, because there's still, even with things like Love and Hate Collide, it's all about relationships because it's something that we can all relate to. I've never been much into Dungeons and Dragons because I've never been in a dungeon, I've never seen a dragon, so my knowledge of such things is pretty limited. So yeah, it was just a pining song, I suppose. Minor chords, very melodic, went major on the chorus. I remember playing it to Mutt Lang once and he went, you wrote this when you were 8? What happened, you know? Where was the follow-up? When I built my recording studio, one of the first things I did to test out the gear was to do a re-record of it, a full-on, like, big, bombastic ballad version for my mum's birthday present. And even that sounds like a proper song. You know, I was fortunate that even at the age of 8, having learned a few chords off my mum, I got the distinct idea that I knew what I was doing. Even though, really, I didn't, but you've got to have the self-belief. Otherwise you will trip up at every hurdle. But I really wanted this. So you get it wrong many, many times, but you keep getting back up again. I started singing when I was about 4 years old. I used to sing along to Paul McCartney and John Lennon and whatever else was out in 1963. 64. I was a huge fan of the Beatles as a kid. I had a plastic Paul McCartney guitar and I used to sing Love Me Do, apparently. These are all phantom memories. They're not memories of mine. These are what I've been told by relatives who used to say, oh, we knew you were going to be a superstar. Because I'd stand on this little table and pretend to be one of the Beatles. I joined the school choir. I didn't sing for years after that. And then when I joined Leppard, I didn't even know if I could sing or not, really. I just stumbled into it. You know, I was very wary of the fact that I wasn't born with a Paul Rodgers kind of voice, but I was always willing to give it a go. There was nothing else to do in Sheffield except work in a factory or become a bank robber or something, or join a band, and that one seemed way more appealing to me. It's no big machine, I told you. The company I keep is so demeaning. I drink until I float up to the ceiling. 1959, we were only, what, 14 years after the Second World War ended. It was still probably a bomb site when I was born. It was rebuilding, but it was just factories.
So you were destined to either, if you lived on the edge of Sheffield, you might end up as a coal miner. You lived in the centre of Sheffield and you were brainy, you might end up as a chartered accountant. Woo! Or you ended up working in a factory, which is what I did. I started life in a factory called Osborne Mushet Tools as a 16-year-old kid. The second I walked in there, I went, God, I'm not doing this for 50 years. You know, this is not for me, you know. Punk rock and glam rock gave me the ambition to, like, try not to. So once I drifted into being in Def Leppard, once we got together, we found each other, again, by synchronicity, I don't know what it was. I missed a bus one night, walked home and bumped into Pete Willis. If I'd not missed the bus, I wouldn't have bumped into him, wouldn't be here now. So it's all, you know, it's sliding doors moments and insane when you wind backwards. The enthusiasm to do the band thing meant I'd keep the job because I so looked forward to going out to the rehearsals every night, and the job paid me the money to be able to buy a microphone and then put money on a deposit down for a PA system so we could play and hear ourselves playing. I was the only guy with a driving license, so when we started gigging, I'd be driving the van. I was literally in charge of the whole thing. And it was my way of kind of compensating for my lack of a voice, I suppose. I think the determination comes from fear of losing it, which is a working class trait, if you like, you know. People will always say to you, oh, take your chance while you can, son, you might only get one, and all this kind of stuff, you know. And I think there is that fear of falling off, that fear of ending up back in a factory or something. You've got to keep going, you know. It's an inbuilt DNA thing, I suppose. I couldn't really tell you. I don't know the definitive answer to any of this stuff, but I just feel that it's what I've always wanted. Enthusiasm, it's just born into me. I don't invent it. I don't tank it up, I don't fill up out of a tank because it's getting low. It's not like a car. It's just there from the minute I wake up. It's like, right, what are we going to do today?